Hello, and welcome back to another episode of All About DMSO. Now, if you watched our last video, Frequently Asked Questions, we briefly talked about DMSO being a solvent, and I thought it'd be a pretty good idea to go into a little more detail on this, because a lot of people don't actually know what a solvent is, or they may have heard the term solvent abuse, which is the dangerous inhalation of chemicals. They don't immediately think about the everyday solvents that we use, or those used in medicine, so that is what we're going to be discussing in this video. According to the dictionary, a solvent is a substance that can dissolve a solute to form a solution. This solution is called a homogeneous mixture. So the solvent, in this case water, is the substance that does the dissolving, the salt is the solute, which is the substance that is dissolved, and the solution is the resulting brine mixture. So now we're more familiar with what a solvent is, I'm going to list some of the more common types of solvent that we can find closer to home. As we've previously discussed, DMSO is an organic sulfur compound. It is also one of the strongest organic solvents and has been used commercially for several decades. Chemically, DMSO is called an amphiphatic molecule. This means it's compatible with both polar and non-polar chemicals, which allows it to dissolve both water-insoluble compounds and mix well with water. DMSO's molecular structure allows many substances to dissolve completely within it. This is one of the reasons why it is widely used as a solvent in a variety of chemical and pharmaceutical settings. These properties allow DMSO to readily cross tissue membranes without damaging them, carrying with it all dissolved compounds. In the 1960s, scientists observed that DMSO penetrates human skin with little effect on tissues, and the solvent was tested as a way for medicines to be carried into the body as an alternative to oral formulations or injectables. As I've just mentioned that DMSO is a solvent that can attack certain types of plastics, I think it might be prudent to also mention that it can attack the varnish on furniture, as well as other synthetic materials. Now, I thought it would be a good idea to have a look at what DMSO can do to some of the items we come into contact with in our everyday lives. Hey everyone, and welcome to my garage, where we're hopefully going to see the effects of what DMSO can do to clothing and furniture if you're not careful with it. So I've got a small piece of plywood, and on one side I've put a couple of coats of varnish, and on the other a couple of coats of gloss paint. And I've also got a couple of pieces of synthetic fibres. So this one's rayon, and this one's polyester. And I've also got a couple of Sharpies out and just put some colour on the fabric so we can see what the DMSO will do to that too. Okay, so I've got my DMSO here. As you can see that, it's super pure DMSO, 99.9% from Regency Organics, which is the brand I always go for. And I'm just going to pour some on each of the fabrics, just a little bit. Okay, there's one, there's two. And I'm also going to pour a little bit on the plywood, don't need much. Okay, and I'm going to take some cotton and I'm just going to rub it round. You see that? And that's got a good coating on that. And then you can see the colour's already starting to run on the fabric. So we'll leave that there. There's the rayon. and the colour's also starting to leach out of that as well. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to leave that give that a little bit of time to work. So we'll leave it for half an hour and we'll come back and see it then. Okay, so it's been about half an hour now. So let's have a look what we've got. I'm going to pick these fabrics up with a couple of screwdrivers because I don't want to touch them. So there's the rail on. I don't know if you can see. It's not very good light in this garage, I'm afraid. But it's starting to bubble. The colour has run. And it's not looking in the best of shape. And then the polyester that I did some markings with the Sharpie. You can see all the colours have run. And that started bubbling as well. And it doesn't look too healthy. So if you was wearing clothing made of polyester or rayon or any other synthetic fibre, you don't want to let any DMSO get on it because it can ruin the clothing. And worse still, it could transfer the colour from the clothing and into your skin. With regards to the piece of plywood, gonna hold it. Oh, you can see where it's affected the varnish there. And if you can see the light there, you just see the paint's bobbled here, and it's also affected the sheen of the paintwork. So when you're applying DMSO and a little drip runs down the bottom to the bottom of the bottle and you put that bottle down on a tabletop, it could actually cause a ring to appear in the finish on your furniture, and you wouldn't really want that. So what I'm saying is always be careful and just treat it with a little bit of respect. Always make sure there's no drips ran down it and put it on a coaster or something that, you know, isn't your best furniture basically. Okay, to summarise this little experiment up, we always advise that when you apply DMSO topically, you should let the air dry it completely before you cover it with clothing or fabrics to avoid any risk of them being damaged, or as I said, transferring the garment's colour into your skin. And I just want to say that this experiment isn't to try and dissuade you from using DMSO, as it is truly an amazing therapy. It's just simply to highlight a few do's and don'ts when you're using it. So as we've seen, we come into contact with solvents all the time. Most of the time we don't give them a second thought, like when we dissolve coffee and sugar in boiling water to make ourselves a drink. Now and then we use solvents and know to use approved precautions, such as wearing rubber gloves and safety glasses to protect our hands and faces when we use certain cleaning products. I think the same principle applies to using DMSO. Treat it with a little bit of respect and reap the rewards it can bring into your life. Always ensure you maintain the highest standards of hygiene when applying it. Use caution where you place the bottle, checking it for drips and keep it away from any expensive furniture and clothing. And always remember to let your skin air dry completely before covering it with clothing. Well, we're almost at the end of this video, so to briefly summarise what we've talked about, as long as you maintain good hygiene when applying it and use a natural material like cotton or cotton wool, DMSO is a perfectly safe natural solvent that can be used for long periods of time. So DMSO could benefit the human body, cells, tissues and organs in unique ways. It's the 21st century's newest healing principle with an extensive range of usefulness. It represents an entirely different means of treating diseases, not just as an ordinary drug that works for any given disease, but as a holistic ingredient that brings whole body cellular function back to normal. Well, I hope this video has been informative and helpful to you, and I hope you're going to check out our other videos as well. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button below if you want to see any more of our content and future videos and updates. Also, you can find us on Facebook and Instagram. Just search for All About DMSO. This is the easiest way to contact us if you need any help and advice, if you have any questions or concerns, or need any other general information regarding DMSO. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.